Yes, ma'am?
I need to speak to the Queen. I need to speak to her.
Ma'am.
Don't fob me off. It is absolutely essential that I see the Queen. This wedding can't go ahead. It'll be a disaster for everyone.
Her Majesty is unavailable at the moment, but I shall...
Is that it? We're not going to talk again, ever?
Since every time we do talk, it ends in an argument, I'd say silence was preferable. What's this I hear about a trip to New York?
Oh, don't look so surprised. The government requested it. Everyone knows I'm going.
No one knew you were going on your own.
What an ugly, avaricious piece of self-advancement that is.
I'd sooner be doing it with my husband by my side.
Doing what? The past few months, you've barely been in a fit state psychologically to go to the hairdresser, much less represent the crown. Although I gather you've still found time to see certain other people.
I think this conversation's gone as far as it can.
You were the one who insisted on talking. I always said silence was preferable.
You sound funnier than the ex.
There you are.
Mama. Well, I'm sure no one told you, but I made a request through my office for us to find a moment to speak together. In private.
Well, I hope you're not wanting to talk here.
No, not here.
Or now. The dogs need feeding.
Dogs?
Yes, the dogs. So if you don't mind, we'll have to find another time.
8 minutes they were on their feet, cheering you. Tomorrow, the newspapers will be about nothing other than you.
And people will see that it was about my feelings for you.
If you had any feelings for me, if you had any understanding of me, if you had anything between your ears other than self-obsession, you'd know public displays like that horrify me.
Everything I do seems to horrify
you. Increasingly, yes.
I never thought you'd manage this, but you're really succeeding now.
And what's that?
I'm starting to properly loathe you.
But what's taking you so long? The rest of us have been there for some time.
One of his awful gurus put him onto it. Well, not gurus, but you know how he loves to surround himself with dreary old men and daddy substitutes.
No.
Darling, you really know nothing, do you? You need a proper Fred tutorial.
So now, hold your horses, decants
into a convoy of limousines and we rush through the streets of Manila.
Lady Diana Spencer, Your Majesty.
I was speaking.
Sorry. Your Majesty. Your Majesty. Your Royal Highness, I didn't see you there.
Evidently not. I was the one telling the story you ruined with your entrance.
Sorry.
This one next.
Sir?
Your Royal Highness, if it's the first greeting,
right.
Then, sir. Now me.
Ma'am?
You don't curtsy to her. She's not royal. Just grand.
Poor Susan. So sorry.
The exquisite selfishness of your motives and the calculated vulgarity of the antics. Knowing full well the headlines they would get.
Antics?
Grandstanding like that. We think we couldn't do that too. Theatrically hug the wretched and the dispossessed and cover ourselves in glory all over the front pages.
I doubt it. You barely find it in yourselves to hug your own.
I hug who I want to. I hug who I love. Particularly when they are affected by the selfishness of others and need cheering up.
Who are you referring to?
Camilla.
Why would I care about her?
Because I care about her! Morning, noon, and night I care about her! And you've hurt her. I know you're not feeling well, but I would remind you, she's not just your mother-in-law, she's also your queen. Diana! Diana! Diana!
No such thing.
There are indeed.
time.
All right.
Honestly, it's pathetic.
Gabriel, please think for me, and Bacchus will please think for me.
All right. What shall I think of?
Think of a beautiful water princess wearing...
It's a different story. He resents me, resents the attention I get.
And why is that?
I don't know. I was hoping you could tell me he's your son.
Because I've been a terrible mother, is that what you've come here to tell me?
No.
Or the Duke of Edinburgh, a terrible father?
Of course not.
I struggle to understand Charles sometimes too. I think that's no secret. But us sitting here sticking knives into him isn't helpful either. And is it also possible that there is a part of you that is enjoying your own success rather too much?
Camilla is who I want. That is where my loyalties lie. That is who my priority is.
Not the mother of your children.
Don't bring the boys into this.
All right. Not the woman you married!
I refuse to be blamed any longer for this grotesque misalliance! I wash my hands of it!
I think we've gone as far as we can for now. We can continue another time.
Oh, don't dismiss me, please. Don't push me away.
What?
Mama. That's all I want. It's all any of us want from you. Is it too much to ask?